Hi everybody, I'm John Riddle, and today we are going to be taking you into the world of music making with a great DAW digital audio workstation, and I'm talking about Apple's Logic Pro 10 and what's new with it for 2025. That sounds pretty good, and I'm going to show you how to use Logic Pro right now. So let's open Logic Pro. When you launch it, the welcome screen appears with several options on the left. You can find your latest projects under Recent and also explore tutorials and demos. Go to New Project to start from scratch. For example, choose Live Loops if you want to experiment or prepare for live looping, or go to Empty Project to create compositions and audio tracks. You can also choose from ready-made project templates according to different music genres. For this tutorial, let's start from scratch with Empty Project. At the bottom, set details such as the project tempo, key signature, time signature, and especially the devices, such as a microphone as input and your speakers for the output sound. You can also set the sample rate and any frame rate if you're working with videos. When ready, click Choose. Logic Pro will ask you to create a new track among several types we will explore later. For now, let's create a new audio track, shown in blue, and set its input and output devices at the bottom. The new track, also called Channel, appears as a horizontal row in the workspace. By default, the workspace is basic and does not display every option. To show all tools, go to Logic Pro, then Settings, Advanced, and check Enable Complete Features. The workspace itself is simple. At the center, you see the main timeline where you record and edit. At the top, you find the time counter, tempo, and other project settings. You can also open additional panels from the buttons on the left and right, which we'll cover later. If you're just getting started, it may help to open the Quick Help panel, which explains the function of any button or tool you hover over. Drag and drop any rendered samples into the timeline to import them, choosing whether to place them on existing tracks or create new ones. You can also find more audio samples you can use from the Loop Browser panel on the right, marked with a blue icon on the left. Just click on these to hear a preview and drag these directly into the timeline. Imported samples are shown as blocks called regions, organized within rows called audio tracks. Each region displays its file name on top and the complete audio waveform over time. To play the timeline, click anywhere above to set the starting point, then use the player controls to start and stop playback. You can also press the spacebar key to play and pause. Whereas, use the Enter key to restart the playback from the beginning. The position of the playhead is shown above in bars and beats by default. You can switch this to seconds by clicking on the arrow on the right. At the top, the project tempo defines the conversion rate between bars and beats into seconds. Rendered samples are not affected in speed rate, but we will see how the tempo may affect composition. By default, the timeline is measured in bars and beats. You can change this by going to the Record tab and disabling Use Musical Grid. To zoom vertically, hold the Option key and scroll with your mouse wheel. To zoom horizontally, hold Option and Shift while scrolling. You can also scroll in time by holding down the Shift key while using your mouse wheel. To play a section in loop, click and drag across the timeline to create a yellow cycle area. Make sure the cycle button is enabled, then press play. Now, let's see how to record using a microphone. Select any track, such as this one, and arm it by clicking the R button. Check if the microphone is reacting by looking at the volume meter. When ready, use the main record button at the top and press the spacebar key to stop. You can also set the counter and metronome options from the top bar. On the left, you can find all the options to manage each track and all the regions inside it. You can right-click to rename, delete a track, or create new ones. When deleting a track, all of its regions will be removed as well. Use the M button to mute a track and the S button to mute all the others. With the volume meter, check and adjust the loudness. And use the panning knob to balance between the left and right stereo channels. For more advanced options, open the Inspector panel from the top left corner. This also shows complete information about the selected track. The same options are also available in the Mixer panel, which is especially useful if you want to see all track settings in one place. In the Inspector, the left section refers to the selected track, while the right one to the master track, or stereo out, which handles the overall sound of your project. Here you find a more extended volume meter, the panning knob, and the volume slider. From the Inspector, you can also add effects, also called plugins, through the Audio FX button. You can choose from a wide range of effects you can apply to the selected track or to the entire project through the stereo out channel. For example, let's take this track and apply a distortion effect, adjusting it from its dedicated interface. Use the I/O button to turn the effect on or off. You can add more effects by clicking in the empty space below the effects list. For example, apply an equalizer or channel EQ. Its filter graph is also represented directly on the track inspector. You can also open the library panel to browse ready-made effect templates for your tracks. For example, pick a template for percussions and see how the track options and effects are applied. To undo the change, simply use Command and Z. Now, let's make compositions. From the Loop Browser panel on the right, you can find several ready-to-use compositions and loops marked in green or violet. These already come with audio, so you don't need to connect instruments or synthesizers. Whereas, if you want to build custom compositions, you have to work with MIDI or pattern tracks. At the top left, click the plus button to add a new track. Besides audio tracks, you can create MIDI tracks, shown in green, which are ideal for melodies or anything based on notes, their octaves, velocity, and duration. You can also create pattern tracks in violet color, better suited for drum parts or repeated steps arranged in time. Let's start with MIDI. Here you can either connect an external instrument, not covered in this beginner tutorial, or choose a software instrument to generate audio with a virtual synthesizer within Logic Pro. Select a synthesizer under Instrument, check the audio output, and go to Create at the bottom. The new MIDI track appears in green color, so select it and open the Editor panel from this button. This opens the piano roll where you can test notes, whose sound depend on the synthesizer you have associated to the track. Enable the pencil tool from the top and click and drag to place notes with the desired length. To compose faster, enable the small play button in the top left corner. Click and drag to move any note in time or across pitches, and drag any edge to adjust their length. Select any note and use backspace to delete it. Use Command and Z to undo. Click on Show Automation to display automation options for each note at the bottom. For example, change velocity for each note by clicking and dragging on each point. You can also switch to Pitch Blend to draw its envelope in time with the pencil tool. Enable the Eraser tool from the top to clear points from the envelope by clicking and dragging on it. To realize loops and drum parts, you can create a pattern track instead. Head to the plus button again, and this time choose Pattern with a software instrument to use a virtual synthesizer from Logic Pro. When the track is created, the editor panel opens on the step sequencer. This works differently from the piano roll, since you only toggle notes sharing the same length on and off to build a sequence. First, set the number of steps per loop, for example 12, on the right. On the left, set the pattern step rate, such as how many steps per bar. The step sequencer shows several rows, one per note. Then, assign notes for each row and turn steps on and off to build your sequence, while using loop regions to compose faster. Above, switch to velocity to set the velocity for each note by clicking and dragging. This is the result. You can see how speed changes if we double the pattern step rate. Keep in mind that MIDI and pattern tracks follow the project tempo. For instance, if you slow down the project tempo, audio tracks will remain unchanged, but MIDI and pattern compositions will follow the new tempo. To manage your compositions, select any MIDI or pattern track and open either the Inspector panel or the Mixer panel. As seen for audio tracks, you can adjust several options, whether it is a MIDI or a pattern track. For example, if we take a MIDI composition, you can change its synthesizer by clicking on the green button. You can select another instrument. Adjust properties through its interface with the central button, or enable and disable the synth with the I/O button. Keep in mind that if you disable the synth, the track will produce no sound. You can also apply effects on compositions. MIDI effects are applied before the instrument that generates sound. For example, this is the transposer effect that shifts the pitch. You can also add audio effects applied after the instrument of the synth. For instance, you can add a filter effect. From the Library panel, you can apply ready-made effects on composition tracks. These may also replace any existing synth. You can add session player tracks to create drums and loops quickly, with the help of Apple AI. Click the plus button to create a new track. Select Session Player in yellow and select between Drummer for percussions and drums, Bass Player for bass lines, and Keyboard Player for pianos. Let's select Drummer and choose the genre and stereo output at the bottom. Then go to Create. This generates a new yellow track opened in the editor panel below. You can loop playback by clicking the small play button on the left. Switch the preset to use at the top and customize the loop with AI, adjusting complexity, intensity, or including and removing specific instruments. You can get more presets from the loop browser on the right, choosing the items with a yellow icon. Be sure to drag them onto an existing session player track to keep the same instrument setup. You can adjust track options from the inspector panel or the mixer panel as seen for other composition tracks. To manage and edit all the regions on the timeline, head to the list of tools at the top and select the pointer tool. To move any region, click and drag it in time or to another track. Drag from the edges to trim it, cutting away part of its content, and drag from the top corners to loop it continuously. This works on audio files and also on compositions placed in loop. Undo any action by using Command and Z. To split any clip, select it, place the pointer on the timeline, and use Command and T. Delete any region by selecting it and pressing the Backspace key. Now let's see how to save and export. To save your entire project content, go to the File tab at the top and choose Save As. Whereas, if you want to render your project as a final audio file, press Command and E. At the top, select the destination folder. Under Range, choose what to export. Select Trim Silence at File End to export the entire project, or Export Cycle Range only if you want to export only the yellow region you defined on the timeline. Always check what you are exporting. If you have any region selected, only that region will be exported. Under File Type, choose the format. Usually the WAV format is recommended, as it is lossless and accepted by most devices and software. Switch to AIFF if you want to keep lossless quality within an Apple environment, or choose CAF if your project is very large and needs special handling, for example, if your project is larger than 4 gigabytes. At the bottom, set the bit depth and then go to Export to complete. In this case, only the selected region within the cycle range has been exported. Hey, thank you very much again for watching our tutorial on Logic Pro. We hope you enjoyed it. And remember to be sure to visit our YouTube channel or our website, where you'll find hundreds of videos on many different softwares that's used for audio production and a lot of them that's used for Macs. So long, everybody. We'll see you next time.